So,
I thought the show here was incredible. It was a big surprise that to be here in Saigon, Ho Chi Minh, just to be in Vietnam period doing some hip hop with a super receptive crowd was awesome.
Same for tracks like Walk This Way, It's Like That, and My Adidas. Run DMC were the biggest hip-hop act in the 1980s. Inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame in 2009, the arrival of former band member DMC to Vietnam marks a turning point for hip-hop in this country.
Rock and Roll and hip-hop is able to say to these Vietnamese people, you know, young and old, even though we're miles from each other, we're basically the same people. When I first got to the airport, the only thing that was really different was the heat because it's winter in New York, but all the mopeds, all the motorbikes, but otherwise they got it going on. The whole King of Rock thing came about when we first started doing, when rap first got on records, a lot of the rappers, there wasn't even rappers then, they were MCs and DJs. Before rap records was ever made, and you had Afrika Bambaataa, Grandmaster Flash and the Furious Five, Treacherous 3 MCs, Funky 4 Plus 1, Cold Crush 4 MCs, Curtis Blow, all of these rap MCs back in the day. So when we started first making our records, there was a lot of competition the way it is now. It just wasn't physically and it wasn't violent. But me and Run and Jay, we was like, yo, what is it that the other MCs ain't doing? Nobody was rapping over the rock and roll records that we rapped along with Chad. We would rap over jazz, blues, funk, folk music, punk rock, and we use a lot of rock records, but nobody was doing it. So we said, we don't want to just be the next big MCs. That's just here in New York. We want to take out Bruce Springsteen and Elvis Presley and stuff like that, because a lot of people didn't believe that hip-hop was a valid form of entertainment.
What kind of advice would you give to promoters within the industry?
That's a lovely question, because they're a big, big part of it. Because in the early days of hip-hop, it was all the promoters that took a chance to bring over the acts to really make a positive effect, especially even for the promoters' business themselves. The promoters got to stop looking at who's hot on a chart and whose video is number one on a video station. They have to go and say, let me go from a worldwide standard, let me see who is the reason why all this hip-hop is popular.
But it happened smoothly. It was great party, great crowd, great.
Okay, as we can see, this little fella got his shirt signed by the man himself, DMC. Please, how did you experience the night? Tell me.
Crazy. But yeah, it's crazy. I love DMC. I'm a big fan, and yeah, it's a good night. Run DMC for life. Yes, RIP JMJ.
Run DMC. Hi, what?
Con này hay, tao này có DMC.
Đây
có DMC rồi, anh chị hay, rất là hay luôn.
Rất là hay luôn á.
DMC là một người.
Thích tại sao em có vì nhạc hay quá thôi hay á.
DMC is the legend.
Oh,
yeah. It's such a privilege because in Saigon we don't get these opportunities very often, and the DMC rocks, like he just owns it.
The number one piece of advice that I'll give to anybody that wants to participate in hip-hop culture, whether it's through music, fashion, or art, is to be original. Hip-hop is about looking at what everybody else is doing and being something different. And what I mean by being original is be true to yourself. Pick your own fashion. Pick your own type of music. Don't try to say, man, I want to flow like Jay-Z. I want to be like 50. I don't even want to be like DMC. Find out who you are and bring that to the world. Yo, yo, what's up, y'all? Check this out. From Ho Chi Minh City, Saigon, Vietnam, Word TV is the place to be. This is... Oh, shit. Bloopers! Bloopers!